The question we're going to look at is question 50 from page 120 of your Science 10 text. All these questions involve calculating the mass of material you have given a number of moles using the molar mass formula. So question 50 has five examples, and in all these questions what we're going to be looking for is the mass of a material. We're going to be using the molar mass formula. The molar mass formula, remember, is molar mass is equal to the mass over the number of moles. In this case, since we're looking for mass, we're going to be isolating m, so we'll multiply both sides by the number of moles. That will cancel, and we're left with then the mass is equal to the number of moles times the molar mass. Now, just for the sake of writing our formula properly, we're going to reverse this. The mass is equal to the molar mass times the number of moles. And so that's the formula we're going to be applying through all of these questions. So the first one says, what is the mass of 2 moles of silver atoms? So the number of moles we're dealing with is 2. We have 3 significant digits in 2.00. The molar mass of silver off the periodic table is 107.87 grams per mole. And since we're just dealing with atoms, that's all we have to worry about. So the mass is equal to the molar mass times the number of moles. So that's going to be 107.87 grams per mole times 2. Again, moles will cancel, and the mass is going to turn out to be double 107.87. That turns out to be 215.74 grams. So I'll just say then the mass is, now to 3 significant digits, we have to write 215, or I should say 216, because we're going to have to round up, but we can't write it as a whole number, so what we'll do is we'll write 2.16 times 10 to the 2 grams, or if we wanted to be sneaky, we could say 0.216 kilograms, so we're using the metric unit to move the decimal place for us. The next example, we have 0.5 moles of lead atoms. So the number of moles, again, that we're dealing with is 0.5. In this case, we only have two trailing zeros, which means we're only dealing with 2 significant digits. The molar mass of lead atoms, again, you can obtain from the periodic table, and it's 207.2 grams per mole on our periodic table. And on our periodic table, it's not known to the nearest hundredth. It's indicating that there's a little bit of difficulty in really establishing what is a typical sample to calculate an average weighted molar mass. Starting with the correct equation, we'll substitute in our values. So the mass of lead is going to be equal to 207.2 grams per mole times the 0.5 moles. So we're half of a mole. So we're going to cancel out the number of moles and left with half of 207.2. So we have 103.2 0.6 grams. Again, we have to express this to two significant digits, and we'll do our rounding and express that rounded value in a sentence. Again, we're going to have to use scientific notation, so I'll just say that the mass is 1.0 times 10 to the 2 grams, or we could, if we wanted to be sneaky and avoid scientific notation, we could say, well, the metric unit kilogram allows us to place a decimal point without having to use scientific notation. Now we have a question in which we're dealing with a molecule now, which is O2. So we're asked to calculate the molar mass of 10 moles of O2 molecules. Now this is given as a whole number, so I'm going to round based on my molar mass. Now the molar mass of O2 is going to be the sum of 16 plus 16 grams per mole for two oxygens. It's a total of 32 grams per mole. Now to calculate, the mass is going to be equal to the molar mass times the number of moles. The mass then is equal to 32 grams per mole times 10 moles. Again, the number of moles cancel, and that turns out to be 320.0 grams. And I can express it to four significant digits without manipulating the value at all. And we'll just say that the mass is 320.0 grams. Now we have a compound, calcium disulfide. It asks us to calculate the mass for 9.67 moles. So I'll write out the number of moles, 9.67. And the molar mass of calcium disulfide is CS2. So that means I'm going to add up 12.01, 32.06 for sulfur, 32.07 for sulfur, and then another 32.07 to accommodate the two sulfurs. That gives me a total of 76.15. So we have a molar mass of 76.15 grams per mole. Calculate the mass, we go back to the molar mass formula rearranged in order to find mass. So we have the mass is equal to 76.15 grams per mole times 9.67 moles, and the mass turns out to be 736.37. That's grams, based on the 9.67, I'm going to have to round to three digits. Again, I'm back in that situation that to round to three digits would be 736, a whole number. I don't want to express it as a whole number. I'm going to round using scientific notation. So again, I'll say the mass is 7.36 times 10 to the 2 grams. So that's the correct way to say 736 to three significant digits. Or, again, when by using the SI unit to move the decimal place, I can say 0.736 0.736 kilograms, and that'll get me the same end result. Our last example now is calcium carbonate. We want to find for 0.832 moles the total mass. So that means I'm going to figure out the molar mass of calcium carbonate first. Now, to calculate the molar mass, we have calcium, which is 40.08. Now, to calculate the molar mass for calcium carbonate, one calcium is 40.08 grams per mole. Carbon atoms are 12.01 grams per mole. Oxygen is 16 grams per mole. We have three of them. And a final oxygen, add them up. We have 8 and 1 is 9, 0, 3 6 is 18, and 2 is 20. And that gives us 100.09 grams per mole. Begin with our molar mass formula, and we wind up with 100.09 grams per mole times the number of moles, which were stated as 0.832 moles, the mass then turns out to be 83.275. I have to round to three significant digits. So that means that I'm going to round up 1, 2 to the tenths place from 2 to 3. So I'll say that then the mass is 83.3 grams. And we're done.